Hello everyone. So today I'm not wearing my glasses. I usually wear my glasses when I do these videos. There we go. Today I wanted to do a quick video about a book that I recently read called The Pumpkin Plan. And I'm not sure how this book came across my radar. It was probably on sale or something like that. But anyway, and I listened to the audiobook, I should say. It's by Mike Michailowicz. I think that's how you pronounce it. And it's about businesses and it's about getting into business. And I think it's very useful for anyone who is an entrepreneur or freelancer like you and who's getting into their own business and for very specific reasons. So let me get into it. The main reason why it's called The Pumpkin Plan, he talks about people who grow pumpkins and that they have these pumpkins competitions. And The way these work is that the biggest pumpkin wins. You've probably seen in the news or something, people show off their great big pumpkin. And he goes into all that, how it works. It's pretty interesting because I knew nothing about it. But he emphasizes the fact that all the average pumpkins, even if they're sort of big, but not the biggest, they're all dumped. And all the concentration is put, all the efforts, all the resources, all the energy, all the money is put into this one biggest pumpkin, the one that's growing best and biggest so that it can be the showcase one. And he kind of translates that into whatever you're doing, that's what you should be doing. You should be dropping everything else, all your side projects, all your, you know, this, that, and the other, and concentrating on your one big thing, the one thing that you're best at, that you're good at, that shows the most rewards, your biggest pumpkin. And I think this is very, at least it resounds a lot with me, because I find myself so often working on something and then, you know, someone will come up with an idea and I'll come up with an idea and I want to pursue it or I want to try a bit of this. I want to see if that sticks or if this works or whatever it might be. And it really is, you know, just the worst thing is it wastes time, which obviously is, you know, I don't have that much of. And very often nowadays, it doesn't even waste that much money because you can do so many things for free or very cheap. But what it does to me is it wastes, well, yeah, like my time, like I said, but mostly my energy and my brain cycles, if you will. When you are an entrepreneur or freelancer, you really have to use a lot of your brain to figure out solutions because the solutions aren't obvious. And it is a full-time thing, you know, and usually when you're in the shower or when you're, you know, not thinking about work is when you come up with your greatest ideas. But if you're concentrating on 3-4 different things, then you're going to miss out on some great ideas for each one of those because you're spread too thin. Anyway, he obviously explains it a lot better than I do, but I do think this is a very important thing for most people when you're first starting out, especially when you're first starting out, because it's hard and you don't know what you should be concentrating on, what's gonna work and what isn't. But you really just need to pick something and go full force all into it, and that's it. And don't spread yourself thin thinking about other things and concentrating on other things. I also like a lot of the other tidbits he has. He has other advice that he talks about, he mentions under-promise and over-deliver 80% of the time, not 100%, and he goes into why basically you don't want the client to get used to you always under-promising and over-delivering. But if you do 80% of the time, then they'll be very happy each time you do it, and you'll always leave a good taste in their mouth, so to speak, because you're under-promising and over-delivering. Obviously, don't do the opposite. What else does he say? Don't let your chosen clients know that they're getting special treatment, because he goes into it, this whole concentrating on pumpkin means concentrating also on your best clients. And if you have a bunch of clients, but a lot of them are taking up a lot of your time or they're just not worth it for you, you should concentrate on the best clients, your preferred ones. If you've studied the Pareto principle, the 80-20 principle, then you've kind of studied this in a way, but he goes a lot more into it. And he's saying, even if these clients that you prefer aren't making you the most money, if you could find all clients like the ones you prefer, they probably will end up making you the most money because you prefer working with them and you look forward to working with them more than the other ones. So he says you should just concentrate on those. But for various reasons, don't let them know that they're getting special treatment as compared to the other ones. I won't go into all that stuff. What else does he have? He said, be very transparent about your methods with your clients, because in this day and age, there's no reason not to. They can find out anything they want to anyway. So if you're transparent about everything you're doing up front, it really makes you stand out and it leaves a good impression for them. And that's about it. The tone during the book, I have to say, was quite annoying at times, but luckily it didn't really detract from the substance. Like, I think he's trying to be folksy and colloquial and stuff, which kind of annoy me every now and then. But the message from the book I thought was very good. Everything he talks about is very actionable, so you can do. What I like with business books is when I can take notes and apply them right away. And I think all business books, by the way, should be read like that. You should never just read it and leave it aside and figure you'll get to it later. No, you should apply them right away. And it's very easy to do with this book. All the steps that he lists are very concrete. Yeah, there's steps that you would probably figure out at some point. Like some of them I was like, oh yeah, I kind of figured that out already. But had I read it at the beginning when I first started out, it would have saved me years of doing things incorrectly. So I do think it's very, very useful for a lot of you people out there. And that's pretty much it. I don't want to get into too much detail about the book, but I'll leave it at that. I do recommend it. I give it 4 stars out of 5 on Goodreads. And by the way, I didn't give it 5 stars out of 5 just because 5 stars, and I explained this before, 5 stars, I save it for game changers and whatnot. This I rated sort of a 4.5, and I kind of average it down. What I wanted to see was wait to see how the results are after I do apply these, and I might push it up to a 5. But either way, it's an excellent book. If you do have access to it, or if you find it anywhere, I think you should look for it. It's not too long. Once again, it's called The Pumpkin Plan, and it is by, let me look it up again, Mike Michailowicz. And so yeah, I hope you found this useful, and I hope you do find it useful. If you have read this book, please feel free to let me know, because I'd love to hear about it. And likewise, if you know of any other books. So I try not to discuss too many books I read here, but only if they have to do A, with language, or B, with freelancing, entrepreneurship, and the business that we do in general. And so if you do have any books you recommend along those lines, feel free to let me know. I love reading in general, and I love reading new books like this that I can find useful and that I can apply. And anyway, that's about it for now. I'll see you in the next video. Savedum!